Hello everyone, good day. So hope everything is going well. So today actually I have planned to cover the for loop pattern, and before going into that I will not waste time by introducing myself. It would be good if you visit the link I have provided in the detail section of the videos, then you will be able to know everything about me. So as you know, if you have already have some classes, previous classes, you know that I am a slow learner. So if you face the similar issues, like if you take the time to know some new technology or to know something new, if it takes time for you as well, then I would suggest to practice more, means do everything by yourself. It is mandatory. And if you starting it now, means if you are already late, I would just recommend you just go through my chapters, just go through, just start and complete at least one class, and complete the exercise. Then I think it will be different. You will feel different. Okay. And after that, I think it will be smooth. It is just, you are just one class away. Just start. Either it may be from my classes, either it may be from books or from some other videos. But I would recommend to start. Okay, then everything will be changed. And do it, do everything by your hand. Okay, type all the programs and run it. And you will face some issues, you will get the error and solve it. Just one chapter. Do the complete cycle and I think and I'm sure that everything will be changed. Just you need to start. Okay, so start today. So going into the chapter, the for loop patterns. So I have segregated for loop in three different parts, that is for loop series, for loop pattern and for loop application. So we have already covered the for loop series, means the basic syntax and how to print some series in for loop using for loop, that we have already checked. So if you have missed those classes, I would recommend you to go from the start. From the starting chapter, that is the chapter one. After that, the starting if, nested if, those chapter, those are the chapter two, and then come to the chapter three. Then you will feel confident. But if you have not done those classes, still there is no issue. You can start it fresh, and just you need to do one thing. You need to practice everything by your hand. Okay. So the second requirement is the time in hand. The first one is better to have those classes first. All the classes are available in my channel, so you can visit them and after that come to the class. Okay, so that would be good. And if not, the second priority is that you can start it fresh, but it should not be okay that you know something and then you come. If you already know something about the for loop patterns, just forget everything. Okay, just forget everything. It would not work actually. Okay, start it fresh. Okay, so today using for loop, we will try to frame some patterns. We'll try to draw some patterns. So what is patterns? Suppose it is given that 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. These are called the patterns. 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, kind of that. So it can be made of stars, 1 star, 2 star, 3 star, kind of that. So what I will do now, I will just treat it as a series. So I will try to find the longest line. So here the longest line is this one. The last line is the longest. And the second last line is the second largest. Okay. So I will try to frame it. So how, so if you do not have any compiler in your machine, so you can use the online compiler. Let me use one of the online compilers and you can do everything. Believe me, everything you can do here in the online compiler. So, okay. Better to type directly online Java compiler. So it will give me multiple options, online Java compiler. Yeah, let me choose the online GDB one. Okay, so I do not require the first few lines. Those are the comments basically. So, and as I have already told you, and if you are new, you can also follow the same. I will not do anything with the first few lines. These lines will be same I would not change anything in these lines. Okay, so I will not modify these parts for in starting few chapters. So now what I will do? Let me go to the program first. Okay, so here the last line, the largest line, is saying 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I will try to do the same. I will try to print the same line. So what I will do, I will take some variable ix kind of. So I will try to frame that I equals to 1, I less than equals to 6, and I plus plus. These are the basic syntax. If you do not know, I can tell you once again that it is basically the loop is starting from 1 and print and iterating till 6, and in between, in the for loop, I will print all the values of I. Okay, I am printing all the values of I. So I will be 1, then 2, then 3, 4, 5, and 6. All the values will be printed. Let me scroll up. Yeah, look, all the values are printed, but I need it to be printed in the same line. So I am removing print ln part and I am giving only print, so that these numbers will be printed in the same line. So just be noted, let me write something. So if I give 6, then it is printing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, right? So if I am giving 6, now I will target the next line. Next line means the next largest line, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so let me draw the same. Now if I give five, now let me check what is the output of the program. It should give 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If I give 4, if I give 4 here, so it should print 1, 2, 3, 4. Let me check. Yeah, it is giving. So what we are getting? Let me write quickly. So if we are getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, if I give 5 in the loop. So if I give, my handwriting is very poor, so just afford that, it will be very tough to handle anyway. So if I give 4, it is giving me 1, 2, 3, 4, kind of that. So in the similar pattern, if I give 1 at last, so I will get 1 to 1. If I give 1, then I will get 1 only. If I give 2 in this pattern, so I will get 1 and 2, right? If I give 3, then I will get 1, 2, 3, right? So I need this pattern 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I need this pattern to be printed. So what I will do, I will use the same series. Means if I let me run by giving 1. So if I give 1 to 1, so what will happen? Just a minute. Okay. So what will happen? It will print just 1. So I need all of those series to be printed. If I give 1, if I give 6, everything should be printed here. So I can see that this place is variable. So I will give x here. X is the variable, means this value is not constant. So I have given a variable x, and the value of x will be provided from the outside of the loop. So the value of x will be 1 at first, and the value of x should be 6 at last, so that this loop will be printed. Means what is the outer loop? Means loop of x basically doing, loop of x basically, the first value of x is 1 and the last value of x is the 6, and x is helping the for loop of I. So x is becoming 1 at first. So when x is becoming 1, the it is printing when x is becoming 1, it is printing 1. When x is becoming 2, this inner loop is printing 1, 2. So when x is becoming 3, this inner loop is printing 1, 2, 3. When x is becoming 4, this inner loop is printing 1, 2, 3, 4. When x is becoming 5, then this inner loop is printing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And at last, when the value of x is 6, here also x is becoming 6, and this inner loop is printing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that the full pattern will be printed. So I have to just decide the starting value of x will be 1, and the ending value of x should be 6. That I have to think. Okay. So I have given x equals to 1, the starting value, and x equals to 6 is the last value. So every time x will be plus plus, and x will take the value 1, 2, 3, 4 respectively, one by one. And this line, actually this loop, the outer loop, I will say it, outer loop means it is in the outside. So I will say outer loop. So outer loop is basically helping the inner loop. The loop is inside. Okay. So this is outer loop, and the below one is the, it is inner loop. Okay. And it is outer. So outer loop is basically helping the inner loop by providing some values. Okay. I think it is clear. If it is not, I will show you multiple programs like that today. Multiple programs until you are clear. Okay. So let me first clear these drawings. Okay. Now let me run the program. Let's see. There is one bug still there. So I will show. So if you print this program, everything, all the series will be printed in the same line, because we have already removed the println. If I put println, all the lines will be printed in different lines, all the numbers. So what is the solution? Look, all the numbers are printed in the different lines. So what is the solution? I will remove the println. So after printing one series, one complete series, suppose our x is 5, so it will print 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So after printing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, what I will do, I will just print a new line. Means I will hit a enter. I will not going to print anything. I will just hit an enter. So it will help me to change the line after printing the successful series. So everything is done by the inner loop, right? Everything is done by the inner loop. What is the role of the outer loop here? It is just helping the inner loop by giving different values. Because we have checked these values, this place, the highlighted place is changeable. Means this place is being changed every time. So I will provide some different values into this place. Okay. And look, we have the pattern got printed successfully. Okay. So let me go to the next program once again. So if it is not clear. So, okay. So for patterns means outer loop to control the lines or the values, and inner loop to print the series. So inner loop is basically doing everything. Okay. And outer loop, you can say it is controlling the lines. If I provide instead of 6, if I provide 5, and if I run the program, it will give me a 5-line pattern, the same pattern till 5-line. So if I give 7 here, or let me give 9, so it will give, it will print the same pattern for the 9 lines. Okay. So the outer loop is basically providing the values and controlling the lines, and everything else is done by, means that series being printed by the inner loop. Okay. Let me go to the next program. So it is the reverse one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. So I will choose the longest line. So it is same like the previous 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, but the difference is the value of x should be 6 at first. So the value of x should be 6 at first, and the last value of x should be 1. And it will be a minus minus. Means if I put in the first line, it should be 6. If I put the value of x 6 at the first line, so what will be printed? It will print 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 by the inner loop. Look, if I put 6 here, let me put 6 here. So if I put 6 here, so what will be printed by this inner loop for I equals to 1 to 6? It will print 1 to 6. So after that, if I put, instead of 6, if I put 5, so this inner loop will print 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, kind of that. So let me write everything. So if I give 5, what we are getting, if I write 5, this inner loop will print 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? If I write 4, if I give the value of x as 4, this inner loop will print 1, 2, 3, 4. And at last, if I give 1, this inner loop will print 1 only, right? So I have changed the way of iteration of x. So now x is starting from 6 and it is iterating till 1. And every time it is x minus minus, means the value of x is decreasing. And I will put x here. So first I will put 6 here in the inner loop, after that 5, after that 4, after that 3, after that 2, and after that 1. So my series, my pattern will be printed. So let me check the same. It is a common sense, basically, means how you have to manipulate the number here. First, you need to identify which place is getting changed by writing the longest line. Okay. So let me do a couple of more programs like this. So the next one is 5, 5, 4, 5, 4, 3, 5, 4, 3, 2, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. Let me write the same here. Okay. Or if you have copy with yourself, you can write the program in your copy. Then it helps actually, rather multiple times going into the slide. So it is better to write this. Okay. So now again, I will try to write the longest line. First, let me delete everything. So I will first write the inner loop, because inner loop is basically doing everything. Let me clear all the drawings and okay. So which one is the longest line here? The last one, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So I will try to write. I will try to print that 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So what I will do? I will do for I equals to 5, I greater than equals to 1, and I minus minus, so that it will print the series successfully, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Only think about the longest line and it will give me all the results correctly. So I'm not going to print ln with a new line. It will be simple print. So system.out.printi. So it should print 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 successfully. Let me check. Okay, there is some errors. Okay. They are asking for, you cannot write this line. It should be in comment. Okay. Give me one moment. Rather you can use some multi-line commenting as well, but I will not going to waste time. So yeah, it is 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It is giving correctly. So now I will choose the second line, 5, 4, 3, 2. So okay, first, let me write. So if I am giving 5, because I am printing the last line. So it is giving me, whenever I am giving 5, it is printing me 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, so it is not 5 basically. Okay, let me first write. Okay, first I need to identify which place is getting changed. So to print 5, 4, 3, 2, to print 5, 4, 3, 2, what I need to do? I need to give it to 2, 5 to 2. To print 5, 4, 3, 2, what I need to do? I will be starting from 5 and simply I will iterate till 2. Then it will print 5, 4, 3, 2. Let me run. If it is printing 5, 4, 3, 2 correctly or not. Yeah, it is printing 5, 4, 3, 2 correctly. So print this line 5, 4, 3. What I need to do? I have to write 5 to 3. So I have checked that this place is getting changes. This 3, 2, 1, this place is getting changes. So what I will do now? So if I put 1 in that place, so it is printing me the last line, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So if I put 2 here, 2 in the loop, it is giving me the second last line, right? Already we have checked and executed. So it is already in the output section 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So if I give now 3 and run this program, let me run this because we have given 3 here. And let me check what is the output. It should give me 5, 4, 3. Right? It is giving me 5, 4, 3. So we are getting this pattern. But the first value, if I gave, So the pattern of the series, if I put 4, it is giving me 5 and 4. So if I give 5 at last, it will give me 5 as a result. Okay, let me give 5. If I give 5, obviously 5 to 5, it should give me 5 result. So look in here, the pattern is getting printed successfully. Pattern is printing successfully. Look, 5, 4, 5, 4, 3, 5, 4, 3, 2, kind of that. So the first value of first value should be 5 here, and the last value should be 1 here. Okay, the first value should be 5 and the last value should be 1 here in this place. But I cannot give multiple values, so I will introduce x here. And the value of x will be starting from 5 and ending to 1. So the starting value of x will be 5 and x will be ended at 1. And x minus minus. That's all. That's all we need to do. And one line, like after printing all the series, means each series, I will print a new line. That's all. So it should give me, it should print me the series, the pattern first. Okay, so let me run it. Okay, it is taking some time. Why it is taking so much time? Just a minute. Yeah, look, it is printing the series successfully. 5, 4, 5, 4, 3. 5, 4, 3, 2, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So what is the key thing here? I have to always go for the largest line, then the second largest line, then the third largest line, and I will have a sense like which place is getting changed. So here we have checked that this place is getting changed every time. So I have to chalk it out and put the values. So after a few days, even you do not need to chalk these values, means you need to write these values, okay? So you can easily, you can print this line. Okay, so let me delete everything and I will go for a new one. If still you have any problem, so you can, you will get multiple chances. So now I will solve a series like 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 4, 3, 2, 1, so kind of that. So let me write this first. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Then 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Then okay, it is, why it is taking the auto value? Anyway, 4, 3, 2, 1. And oh my god, why it is taking the auto correction? I'm not asking for okay. 2, 1, and 1. Let me check if it is correct or not. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, yeah, it is correct. So I will go for the longest line. So now the longest line is 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So let me write the program quickly for I equals to 6, I greater than equals to 1, and I minus minus. So it should print the correct series, the longest line at least. So print I. Okay. So let me, yeah, minimize this one. Okay, so yeah, this line means 6 to 1 should print me the first line, six, the longest line, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, it is taking some time to be executed. Okay, so it is giving 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 correctly. So now if I go for the next line, that is 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So yeah, it is, the next line is 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So if I go for this line now, so what I need to do? So I need to change this value to 5, right? So that this second largest line will be printed if I put 5 here. So let me run it quickly. So yeah, it is giving 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 correctly. So what is happening if I write, so whenever I am giving 6, I am getting the first line, that is 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So whenever I am giving 5, I am getting the second largest line, that is 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, in an order, if I give four now, I should get 4, 3, 2, 1, right? Let me check it once first. So if I give 4 here and let me run, it should be 4, 3, 2, 1. Look, it is giving 4, 3, 2, 1. So this place, I can see this place is variable. I cannot put any fixed value in this place. So rather, I will put an X. Okay, and what will be the value of X? The value of X will be changing. So the first value of X should be 6 to print the first line. Okay, to print the first line, the first value of X should be 6. And after that, the value of X should be 5, means it should decrease. After that, it should be 4, and it should iterate till 1. Okay, I hope you are able to understand. I'm not saying much because it is the fourth example I am showing. I think you have started understanding this. It will be more clear whenever you will be solving the exercise. Okay, but still, this place is variable, and the value of this place will be changed from 6 to 1. So the first value will be 6 and the last value will be 1 in that pattern, so that these lines will be printed. So the key loop is the inner loop. So you have to first write the inner loop. Then the outer loop actually provides the value to inner loop. That's all. And it will control the number of lines. So whatever I will do now, so I will rather print a new line. After each successful lines, I will just print a enter. I will just hit a enter. So let me check if this program is printing the series correctly or not. Okay. Yeah, it is printing 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 correctly. Matching with this. Okay. So if you face any problem, you can go back to the video and you can check the class once again, and I think you can take a break before going further, because it will be more complex patterns will come. So you can take a break if you want. Okay, so the next thing is we will all together cover 6 topics in this chapter. So the first topic is printing star. So we will not learn any more syntax. Syntax are okay. Using the same syntax, we will solve 6 logic. So first topic is the printing star. So how to print star? Okay. So first we will check this star pattern. So here it is printing 1 star in the first line, 2 star in the second line, 3 star, kind of that. So what I will do to print these stars? Okay. Let me delete all this. Okay. To print a star. Okay, so it should be I1 less than equals to 1, I++. So I just need to print a star here. It is the same, nothing new. So if I run this, it will print 1 star. One error, I have done some mistakes. Where I have done some mistake? Okay, 1 extra bracket I have given. Sorry. Yeah, so let me run the program. So 1 to 1, it will print 1 star. I have just replaced the number with star. That's all. So if I give 1 to 2, it will give me 2 stars. Yeah, it is giving me 2 stars. If I put 3 here, so it will give me 3 stars. Now I have to print a pattern of 6 height. Height is 6 here. So what I will do, this place will be variable. this place, let's take it as x. So the value of x will be starting from 1, because in the first line I need to print 1 star, and the last line the value of x should be 6, because the height is 6, and in the last line 6 stars will be printed. So x equals to 1 to 6, x plus plus, and it will print the stars in each line and system.out.println star. Only println. So let me run this. So in the first line, the value of x is 1, so that it will print 1 star. After that, the value of x will be 2, it will print 2 star. After that, value of x will be 3, it will print 3 star, and accordingly. Okay, let's wait. It is taking some time. Yeah, it is giving 6 stars. Okay, good enough. So let me go to the next problem. So I will give multiple examples in this chapter. So do not worry if you still getting some problem. Just look into that and try yourself. Okay. So it is a reverse pattern. So in the first line, it is printing 5 star, then 4 star, kind of that. So what I will do now, let me do something different. So let me try something different, because we are doing already. Or let me first do the older way, follow the oldest way, then I will show you the new way. So here in the first line, it is printing 5 stars. So what to do to print the 5 star? 1 to 5, obviously, right? So after that, to print 4 star, it should be 4, right? It should be 3 to print the 3 star. So this place is variable. I will give x, and the value of x should be 4. X equals to, the first x should be 5, so that if I put 5 here, it will print 5 stars. Okay, so the first value, because it is a reverse structure of star, so x should be 5, and x greater than equals to 1, and x minus minus. The first last value of x should be 1. Okay. So I am what I'm doing, x equals to 5, x greater than equals to 1, and x minus minus. And the value of x getting changes. So the whenever the value of x is 5, it is printing 5 star. After that, the value of x is 4, it is printing 4 star. So after that, the value of x is 3, it is printing 3 star, and so on. Okay. Clear a bit now. So let me print this one. Star hash, star hash. So let me first four height series. So whatever I am telling you, to show a new way. So to print a star series, what I will do, for I equals to 1, first I will write the outer loop now. Just let's try something new. Okay, that's why. Otherwise, you can follow the old way if you feel comfortable. So x equals to 1 to 4 and x plus plus. So now what I will do, to print a star pattern. So I am trying actually to print a star pattern like this. I am trying to print a star pattern like star, 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 and star, 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 star. Okay. These stars are basically to to give a comment, we can use this star slash. So actually I am trying to print this pattern. 1 star, 2 star, 3 star, and 4 star. So now I will start from the outer loop. So x equals to 1 and 4. That means it will iterate for 4 lines. And at the end of every line, the logic will be same anyhow, but you have to think in a different way. So after each line, I will hit an enter. And before hitting an enter, what I will do, I will try to print the series. So it is 1 star, I guess. Yeah, at the top line, it is 1 star, then 2 star, then 3 star. Okay, so to print 1 star at first, what I will do, I equals to 1, I less than equals to x. Because the value of x is 1 at first, so 1 to 1, okay, 1 star. And after that, the value of x will be 2. That means I equals to 1 to 2, that means 2 star. So after that, the value of x will be 3, and it means I equals to 1 to 3. Okay, listen carefully, 1 to 3, that's right, 3 start. So the at last value of x will be 4. So here it will be 1 to 4, that means 4 star will be printed. So I will simply write print a star, that's all. Okay, let me run this. It should print the pattern correctly. Yeah, it is printing the pattern. So now it is asking for star hash. So if I give, instead of star, if I give hash here, it will print the same series of hash. So whatever you will give, it will be printing the same series. So instead of hash, now I will give star hash, both. So it should print a pattern of star hash, one star hash, two star hash, three star hash, four star hash, kind of that. But if you check, it is printing one hash extra every time. In the first line, it is only star. Second line, it is star hash star. But if you check here, it is star hash star, one extra hash. So it is printing one extra hash every time. So what I will do, I will print one star hash less. I'm not going to print this star hash. I will print one star hash less. Okay, so what I will do now, I will just simply x minus 1, because this for loop is responsible to printing a line. So I am just doing x minus 1. Whatever I have decided to print, I will just print one less. Okay, so let me run this first. So in the first line, it will not print anything. In the second line, it will print one star hash. In the third line, it will print two star hash, just one star hash less. But I need to print one star at the end before hitting enter. So before hitting enter, I will just print a star before hitting enter, and it will just cover whatever I want. Okay, so look, now it is printing correctly. So this is the logic. Again, this is the logic. Syntax we have already learned. We are good in syntax. We are not going to learn any more syntax in this chapter, but it's about logic. So my purpose is to build the logic in your brain. Okay. It is not about the compiler I will use. It is not any compiler you can use, any software you can use, any questions you can solve. But the thing is, you have to be sound enough, or you have to be intelligent enough to solve the logic. Whenever you get a new pattern, you have to think means the way to print that pattern efficiently. So that thing I am trying to build the logic. So that is important. Okay. So now we are able to print the star patterns. So we will go now into the topic two. So topic two, it is saying printing patterns with some number series. So number series means it is now first asking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, kind of that. So first I will use the same series. If I write star here, let me delete this one. So if I print the star, it will print a 4 line. Okay, sorry. Some adjustments I need to do. Let me delete the previous lines as well. Okay. Now, if I run this, it will print me a 4 height star pattern. So if I give hash, it will give me a 4 height hash pattern. Whatever you will give, it will print the same. If I give suppose a new variable, say m or z equals to 1, say. So if I print now z, what will happen? It will print 1 1 1. So all the ones will be filled out. Look, right? So now if I just do one small thing, after printing the value of z, I will just increment the value of z. So what will happen now? It will just print 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, kind of that. Let me check. Yeah, it is printing our series. So the pattern, listen carefully this part. I have not changed any single thing on the pattern. So pattern is not dependent on what you are printing. Pattern will print this pyramid structure. Okay. Pattern will just print this pyramid structure, and whatever value inside you can print. So it is rather easy. So I have introduced one new variable z, and I am trying to print Z with incremented value every time. Every time it is getting printed, I am incrementing the value. So after that, it is asking for 1, 2, 3. Okay, look, first you need to understand what will be the sixth line. The sixth line should start from 6, 7, 8, 9, kind of that. So first you have to take a look at the logic. So what will be the next line? It should be starting from 6, right? So this line is important. It is starting from 6. After that, this line is, it is starting from 7, right? So the line means the series is starting from the line number itself. It is the first line. So the value is starting from 1. It is the second line. So the value is starting from 2. It is the third line. So that the series is starting from 3. It is the fourth line. So the series is starting from 4. Means the Z is starting from 4. Say. Okay. So the, it is the line number itself at first. So I will try to capture the same using Z now. So what I will do. The value of Z I will not introduce here. I will introduce the value of Z here. So Z will be. Z will take, will take the value of X. So X is 1 means in the first line, X is 2 in the second line, X is 3 in the third line, X is 4 in the fourth line. So Z will take the value of X before entering into the printing loop. So this loop is basically printing line. I am saying this from the starting. This loop is everything. So this loop is basically printing the series. So before starting this, before entering into this loop, I will assign the value to Z. So Z will take the value of the current line number. So after that, I will print Z and Z will be plus 1 every time. So let me check. So this printing of some number series is rather easy. Okay. So I hope it is correct, but it is asking for 5 lines, I guess. Yeah, it is asking for 5 lines. So what I will do, I will just print it till 5 lines. That's all. Let me check. Yeah, it is giving me correct answer. Okay. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, good. So going to the next problem, it is 1, 1, 3, 1, 3, 5. Look, every time the series is starting from 1. Every time series is starting from 1. So again, one small adjustment, Z will be starting from 1 every time. And after printing each number, Z is incremented by 2. That's all. So this loop, again, I'm saying this loop is basically printing the series. So before entering into this loop, Z will take a value like 1 every time. And it is printing every time Z will be Z equals to Z plus 2. Means 1, then 3, then 5, kind of. Okay, so if you have any doubt or if you have any problem like this, means you are not able to solve this one, like you may think that, okay, sir, it is already given, so that you are quickly adjusting this problem, means you are quickly running writing this code. So it will be good if you provide me some of the examples like this. If you are not able to understand, I will help you to show how should you write the code. Okay, so if you still face any problem with the pattern, you can comment on the video comment section, or you can send a mail to me with the questionnaire that these questions I'm not able to solve. If I get time, obviously I will reply. Okay, but you need to practice it, practice all the programs I am showing in your compiler. It might be Blue Java, it might be Eclipse, or it might be an online IDE, anything, anywhere. But you have to think the logic by yourself. That is important. Okay. So I think we have covered topic 2. So now let's move to the topic 3. It is series dependent on the line number. So look, in the first line, it is always printing 1. In the second line, it is printing 2. In the third line, it is printing 3. In the fourth line, it is printing 4. So it is very easy. You can take Z equals to X, okay? And Z every time you print Z. That's all you need to do. It is very easy. Z is not, the value of Z will be fixed into the line. Otherwise, even it will be more smart actually, it will be if you delete Z and just directly use the value of X. So the value of x is 1 in the first line, so always it will print 1. The value of x is 2 in the second line, so 2 will be printed. That's why I always, it helps actually, I always like to take the for loop of x as 1 to 5. I do not prefer to take it 5 to 1 in some cases. I always like to take the value as x equals to 1 and x will be 5. It makes me feel easier, like if x equals to 1, that means you are in the first line. If x equals to 2, you are in the second line. It seems tougher for me to think like a way, x is 5 means you are in a first line. X is 6, x is 4 means you are in a second line. It is making things complicated. So it will be easier if you take x equals to 1 means you are in the first line. X equals to 2, that means you are in the second line. So I will try to keep this for loop as it is, x to 1 to 5. Yeah, it might be 6 if they require 6 lines of program. It might be 4 if they require 4 lines of program, but it might change. But I will try to not to change this for loop. Okay. So let's see the next program. It is 5555444333221. Okay. So 5 fives. So now it will be easier. It will be easier if you write 5 here. But I'm not going to do that. I will write x1 means I am in the first line, x2 means I am in the second line, kind of that. So now I have to print all 5s in the first line. So before that, I have to adjust this loop. How to print 5 stars in the first line? How to print? So let me think. It should be good if you write I equals to x to 5. Okay, I equals to x to 5. So whenever the value of x is 1, it will print 1 to 5. So whenever the value of x is 2, it will print 2 to 5, means 4 stars. So let me try this with star first. So first I am trying to bring the pattern. Okay, whatever. Okay, I have done one mistake, silly mistake. Yeah, I do not need this one. Yeah, anyway, so it should print the correct structure. Yeah, 5 star, 4 star, 3 star, 2 star, 1 star. Yeah, now I can fill this out using any variable. Say z equals to any number you can take, z equals to 5, say. So I will print z. Okay, and after each line, you can say, after each series, means after each line printed or series printed, you can do z equals to z minus 1. Let's take a look. So it is also important to understand your error by checking the error message. So it will be good if you face some error message and try to understand what is the error message is. So everything will be written clearly in any compiler that it is the mistake. So you have to check and correct the same. Okay. So 5555443321. So it is rather easy. So there is a way, again I am telling, there is a way to do this program. Like if you do not use Z, if you use x even, x equals to 5, x equals to 1, and x minus minus. So, and the value should be 1 to x. That means 1 to 5. First, after that, the value of x will be 4 here. So, it will be 1 to 4, 4 star kind of that, so that you do not need any more z. It will be enough if you print x. So any logic you can implement, but I do not like to iterate x from 5 to 1. That means x equals to 5 means it is x equals to 5 in first line, x equals to 4 in second line. Rather, I prefer to think like in a way like x equals to 1 means I am in a first line, x equals to 2 means I am in a second line. Okay, these lines are, I am saying it is very important. I will recommend to go back and listen these lines carefully. Okay, this is another way to print the same series, same pattern. Okay, but I do not prefer this way. I always prefer to keep x equals to 1, x less than equals to 5. It helps me to solve the complex patterns like this. Okay, so there is no scientific way, means you can choose any way, but still it helps me. Anyway, so going to topic 4 quickly. So it is the pyramids. So first pyramid is this one. So we have already printed the pyramid like a normal one. So what is the difference here than the previous one? So here actually it is printing actually some spaces before this star. Some spaces, as spaces are invisible, so that you are not able to see the same. Okay, so there are some spaces. Okay, so first it is 4 spaces, then 3 spaces, then 2 spaces, then 1 spaces. So I will try to capture the same. First, I will try to print a star pattern, means 1 star, then 2 star, then 3 star. I will try to draw a pattern like that first. Okay, so let me do it first. Okay, so it will be simple. X equals to, we have done couple of times today, x equals to 1 2, x equals to what was the number of lines, so let me check first. It is 5. Height is 5, so let me write a 5 size program. X equals to 1 2 5, and I equals to 1 2 x, and I will print star. Okay, let me first check if I am able to print the pattern of star successfully or not. Then I will try to press. Yeah, I am able to print. So now before this star, I will try to put 4 spaces. Means before printing this star and hitting enter, I will try to print 4 star here. Somehow, I don't know how to print, but I will try to print some spaces here. In the first line means the value of x is 1. So it is easier to understand. Okay. So in the second line, I have to put 3 spaces. And after that, 2 spaces. So it is, if you make it tough, then you can think some logics, but it is actually some star patterns. These are the stars. If you think to print some stars with 4 stars first, after that 3 stars, just think like in that way. After that, print space. Okay. So think like that. 4 star, then 3 star. We have already solved these problems. Okay. 4 star, 3 star. If you check the topic, previous topics, so we have already done that. Okay. So I need to print this. 4 star, then 3 star, then 2 star. So whenever the value of x is 4, sorry, the value of x is 1, I need to print 4 star. So what I need to do? I will introduce I equals to, let me think, x and I less than equals to 5. So if I give a series like this, x to 5, means in the first line, the value of x is 1, means 1 to 5. And it will print me 5 spaces. So better to reduce it by 1. So I need actually 4 spaces in the first line. So in the second line, the value of x is 2. We already know, I have already told you many times. So x equals to 2 in the second line. So 2 to 4 means 3 spaces. I need 3 spaces, I guess. Yeah, I need 3 spaces in the second line. So I think it should work. Okay, let me delete all the drawing. Yeah, let me now quickly run this program. Okay, sorry, I have done one mistake. I have put a comma after out. Okay. Okay, it should print the pattern correctly. Look, it is printing the pattern. Okay, so there are 4 spaces printed in a line. After that, 1 star, and then enter. Again, in the next line, it is 3 spaces and 2 stars and 1 enter, kind of that. Okay, so let me take a backup of this program. Let me take a backup. Okay, so this is the way you need to print. Okay, so now what is the next program? Let me check pyramids. Okay, this one. So this one, actually, anyone might be confused that, okay, this is the tougher one. But I would say this is a simplest one. If you can do the first series, first pattern, then it is very easy. Just one letter change. One letter you need to change. It is so that easy. Okay, so one letter change only. One letter. Okay, not even a line you have to change. It is only a letter. Okay, so what I need to do actually here. So these two series are basically same. So if you put one, if you inject one air bubble in between these two stars, it will become this one. So if you inject one air bubble inside this, just imagine by your common sense, and one air bubble inside these two spaces, it will become this line. So now if I inject air bubble or space, I am saying air bubble to give you an impression in your mind. So if I put an air bubble here and here and here, so it will be a line like this. So it is very simple actually. So let me do the same in our program. So this pattern is printing this pyramid. Just give me a moment. Yeah, it is printing this pyramid. So now I will try to print, I put a space in between these two stars. So what I will do, I will just write star space, that's all, and just one letter change, and it will print our desired pattern. So I just basically I am just putting some air or some spaces between the stars, and it will print the desired pyramid. Okay, look, where is our program? Yeah, this one. Okay, I guess it feels good now. Okay, let me go to the topic 5 quickly. So in topic 5, it is saying complex patterns like this, 1 to 1, 1 to 3 to 1, kind of that. So here actually after every line we will be hit a enter. Every time we will hit a enter. So before hitting enter, actually we will hit a enter in the same pattern. So to go to the next line, so before hitting enter, what I am doing, I am printing a forward series from 1 to 5, and after a backward series 4 to 1. So let me first print this forward series for the largest line, 1 to 5. Let me do that first. So let me delete this one. Let me print the forward series. So for I equals to 1 to I less than equals to 5, I plus plus. So it will print 1 to 5, right? Don't go for the x equals to 1 and those all. So let me delete them. Okay, so it will print the forward series, and let me write system.out.println. Right, sorry, not star here, it will be again I. So I equals to 1 to 5, so it will print me a forward series like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Same, I will print, I am able to print the backward series as well. So it will be 4 to 1, I equals to 4, so I will decrease and it will be till 1, 9 minus minus. So I am actually, what I am trying to print this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 4, 3, 2, 1. And it should print the series correctly. Let me run the same. Okay, it is printing in this different line because I did a foolish thing. I have not removed the ln part. So now it should give me everything in the same line. Look, it is printing everything in the same line, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So now what to do? Now I will focus on the second largest line. So second largest line means this 1, 2, 3, 4 and 3, 2, 1. So I will try to print 1, 2, 3, 4, then 3, 2, 1. Okay. So let me do the same. So it will be 1, 2, 4 and 4, 3, 2, 1. Look, it will give me the series correctly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 1. Look. right? It is printing the pattern, printing the series correctly, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 3, 2, 1. So now I will write a common loop. Means I will change the values, x equals to 1, x less than equals to 5-line series, I guess. So 5-line pattern, sorry. So it will be, instead of 4, I will give x. And instead of 3, I will write x minus 1. Because whenever the value is 4 here, it is replaced by x, and it is 3 here. So I will replace the same with x minus 1. And after printing this series, I will hit a enter every time. Okay. So let me run the program. Hope it is clear now. It is really good if you are really understanding this problem. So it is really good and appreciable. Okay, so yeah, 1, 1 to 1, 1 to 3 to 1, 1 to 3 4, 3 to 1, kind of that. Look, it is printing the series correctly. So whatever is there in your question paper or in front of you, the pattern you can print, you have to just think and use your for loop efficiently to print that pattern. So that's what you need to do. Okay, so it is now okay. So let me clear all the drawings. Yeah, so let me go to the topic 5. So now there is a last program we need to do. So it is the printing a new pattern, a pattern with any line number. Okay, so any line number. So till now we have not taken any input from the user. We are just printing the pattern like 4 height, 5 height, 6 height, like that. But now user will give me the input that I want to print a pattern of 8 lines. I want a pattern, I want to print the same pattern with 20 lines. So now the last program we have done, so it is asking for n lines. So what I need to do, I will take an input from the user, the same pattern. So you do not need to be think much. Just write the pattern. The first part is just write the pattern till 5 lines or 4 lines or 3 lines, anything. After that, take an input. After that, only after that, take the input. Okay, so take the input. I need to introduce a couple of lines like import java.util.star. System.in. Okay, and after that I will have to take an input from user. I have to give some message to user, enter the number of lines. Okay, so they will give me, and they will enter the number of lines using this statement, n equals to sc.nextint. If you do not know these lines how to take input, you can cover that class 1. You can find all the details in my channel. So the class 1 you have to do how to take those inputs and all. So but I think for most of you it is clear. So now n is the line number. So all the hard coding parts, so suppose you have written the same program using line 5, like we have written the program for line 5. So some of you may write the program for line 4 or line 3. So now the line will be replaced by the user given input, that is n. So all the hard coded parts, like our program is the height 5, so I will remove this 5 and put n, and that is enough. I do not have any other hard coded part like 5, so you do not need to change anything else. So just replace the hard coded 5 part 5 with n. So now let me write. Nothing you need to check. Just write the program using some custom lines. It might be 5, it might be 4, it might be 3, anything you can give. Then replace that 5 or 4 or 3 with n. So now let me give 5 first. Yeah, if for 5 it should run because we have already checked. Now let me give some bigger numbers. So let me give say 8 now. So look, it is the same pattern is being printed for 8. It's cool, right? Okay, so let me go to the next problem. So it is the star pattern and it is printing till n lines. Okay, so first let me write the star pattern. let me delete everything. Star pattern should be x equals to 1, 2, x less than say 5 again. Say 5. So 1 to 5. Yeah. So this should print the pattern correctly. So let me delete this line. I do not require. First I'm interested to print the pattern. After that, I will convert it into the n lines. So let me print the pattern first. Yeah, it is printing the pattern. So it is still 5 lines. So what I will do now, I will introduce the input from user n and all the hard-coded parts. Means 5 is a hard-coded part. I will replace it with n. Okay. And let me now print the same series, same pattern. So it is asking for the number of lines. Say I will give 20. So it should print me a pattern of 20. Look, right? Okay, cool enough. So you do not need to think much on the dynamic, how to make the code dynamic. It is very easy. It is very easy. Just replace the hard-coded part with your with the n. Okay, so we have already covered all the topics for the for loop patterns. So it will be good if you really want to learn something. It will be good to solve the exercise. So the exercise will be available in our Facebook group. So let me show you the how to get that exercise from the group. So this is our group. So you need to go to the photos section, and there will be finding an album. And in album, there will be something like coding exercise basic. Go to that album only. And there are several topics. We have already covered few of the chapters in our previous classes. So go to chapter 3.2. Just a minute, not this one. Yeah, this is the chapter 3.2 and it is a for loop pattern. So you can solve all of them till the next page, till here. Don't go for the for loop application, because for loop application we will be covering in our next class. So for today, you can solve this one and send me a copy to my mail ID. I will check and I will give a feedback if you face any problem. And if you face any other problem, you can give a comment on the comment section of the video that said I'm not able to understand this topic and this. So yeah, I will try to solve that one as well. Okay, so thank you and best of luck. So solve this exercise and do all the programs by yourself. Okay, bye for today.